Hello?
Hello, everyone. Had a really bad night, really bad morning. Not because of the hater, it's not that at all. The denial is it sheds its protective space. It became very clear to me as I had to call a realtor this morning, one that I could maybe trust, that the narcissist hasn't gotten to. Not really sure yet. A series of synchronicities, weird things happened today, and I don't know. The beginning of my vlog, which I locked up now because some people were getting so confused. I talked about my cat. It was a black and white snowshoe kitty. Actually, it was in an abandoned house next to my girlfriend, and she talked me into taking him, and I did. And he was absolutely wonderful. That was when I first met the narc. And I went on a business trip to Kentucky, and I asked him, I trusted him, please, just keep an eye on the house and make sure the cat has food and water. Here's the key. He poisoned my cat. It's funny, I knew it. I came back and my cat was peeing all over the place. The vet diagnosed him as diabetic, but I knew that wasn't it. He died shortly thereafter. I'm sure that the narcissist poisoned my cat. I remember it was clairaudient. I remember the voice in my head that said, you know, he had something to do with this because your cat was perfectly healthy. And then you came back from your trip and he wasn't. I remember calling the narc immediately saying, was there an accident? Did he get into something? Did he fall? He's acting so very, very strange. It was the psychopath. That, and then you'll hear me talk about the finches. And this is where the narcissist was taking me to a greenhouse up in Lake Geneva, Pesci's greenhouse. It was beautiful, family run. And they had kept in the greenhouse two giant bird cages full of finches. And I love them so much. Every weekend I would go up and just talk about the finches, and I thought, God, they just really add such an ambience to the entire greenhouse. What a great idea. I have these beautiful birds there chirping and in the sunlight, all that stuff. Well, they knew I was taken with them quite a bit, meaning I like them a lot because I love birds. And they decided they were changing things up. And one weekend, as we're checking out, they say, take the birds with you. Take them with you. The cages and all. We don't want them anymore in the greenhouse. And you can have them, everything. So I took them. Finches, by the way, quite something. The males, you can't have two males in a cage. I found out they kill each other. They're territorial. And the females lay eggs non-stop. Whether they hatch or not, that's another thing. But mostly, if they do, the babies, at least when I had them, didn't really make it. So it was quite the experience raising finches. But anyway, I went to work middle of the week. My daughter, my kids, both of them love the finches. They love to see how many new eggs were hatched. And I didn't show them the babies that were pushed out of the nest or anything like that. But there was these little tiny eggs, and they did make some lovely little noises. I made sure they were high up on the ceiling. I had a dog that was AC or Ace, the Lhasa Apso, and I grew up with animals, so I was very careful to make sure that everything was secured or nothing happened or one couldn't get at the other. That happens. And my kids were still young. Very responsible, but they were still young, so I just wanted to make sure they couldn't reach the cage. So it was the middle of the week, and I come home, and the finches are gone. I had four left. Gone. The door wasn't open. There wasn't a feather anywhere. I scoured the house three times looking for a feather, something. Thought, well, if by chance that door was left open, the dog maybe ate them, and dogs are messy. So they don't they leave remains behind. Nothing, not a feather. The door was locked on the cage. I always made sure because I'm very responsible when it comes to animals. It was the psychopath. Today, when I asked him about it, I knew what he did. He had a key. This wasn't a business trip to Kentucky. I wasn't gone. I was at work for just the afternoon. He came in the house. He let those birds out. Carefully closed the door, locked it. Thank you, narcopath, because now I know for sure it was you. He lied. I confronted him about it today. And he said, "Don't you remember we were up in Lake Geneva, blah 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 blah." No, it was the middle of the week. The strangest thing, I came home and they were gone. I couldn't find them. I didn't have time to even process it because I had two kids that I had to explain. The birds are gone. I don't know why. And I had a dog thinking maybe he ate them. I don't know. And I spent the next week going over the house with a fine-tooth comb, looking for those feathers, something, anything, some evidence of something. There was none. It was the psychopath. And today, when I confronted him about it, he lied, of course. I said, "That's not true. First of all, his best lie would have been denial. I don't know what you're talking about," he should have said, but he didn't. He went into greater depth. Because, people believe the lies that you go into great detail about. And I knew. Right then and there, he was the one who, in the middle of the week, while I was at work and my kids were at school, came to my house with the key I gave him because I trusted him, and released my finches, or did something with them. Just for the fuck of it. Just to fuck with us. Can you imagine? I was barely dating this guy at this time. Maybe 6 months to a year into it. And I also know that he poisoned my cat. I know he did. All the signs were there. I knew it when I came home. I'm like, you're the only one who was here. Why is he acting like this? This is strange. But I would go to his mother's house, and they had a Tom. They had a cat. They called Tomcat, and then of course their dog, their own dog. And I thought, there's no way he lives with these animals. How could he do that to me? But he did. And can you imagine the mind fuck? The mind job he did on me and my daughter after that. Remember the fake diamond in the engagement ring? He got someone to help him with that. And now I'm trying to sell the house. And he did it to his lawyer. If his lawyer's not just like him, that's pretty obvious. And, he did it to the cops. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? When I was sick, why I stayed sick. There's another story about that too, but for now, this is one of the really, really bad days that you have. When you realize what a huge, monumental mistake you made, try not to blame yourself. Because they're psychopaths. They fool everyone. But still. Anyway, not sure if that's going to help anyone today. Peace out.